And it's time for your Gianavolpi report, brought to you in part by Village Overhead Door and Cell Phone, by the Duncan Inn in Jamesport, by the Crazy Fork in Mattituck, by Feisty Acres in Jamesport, and by Tweed's Restaurant and Buffalo Bar in Riverhead.
Hi, 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 Mr. Tria.
Good morning.
How are you?
I like this. They're both wearing sunglasses. Abra Moraviak, did I pronounce it correctly this time?
It was incorrect again, Bruce.
Moraviak.
Yeah, yeah. But you can just say Morawick because, you know, we're all American here.
Yeah, right. Bruce, I see you've got your pickled eggs already.
I got them, yeah. This reminds me of the gefilte fish taste-off.
Trust me, it's going to be a lot better than gefilte fish.
That was awful. And I covered that stuff up.
These are going to be fabulous.
I covered that stuff up in horseradish.
So you make these at the Backyard Brine Pickle Factory?
That's correct. Yeah, I
Well, you two talk. I got to get a fork. I don't want to reach into the brine.
Why? That's really authentic to do that. Just stick your mitts in there.
Yeah, get on in there.
Get at it.
It's pickle.
Oh, there he goes. Yeah, get it, Bruce. Word. Okay, yeah, take the dill off. You know, that's, you know.
I love dill.
No, I know, but, you know, it can mar the taste, the delicate taste.
The delicate.
What do you think?
Can't talk his mouth full.
Yeah, okay, he's not choking. That's a good sign.
That's good.
They're good?
Mm-hmm.
I know they're good.
Pretty good, Abby.
I grew these.
Well, you know what they're really great in? So they're really wonderful in... Do you drink martinis, Bruce?
No.
You should start, because you should substitute one of those olives
for the olives?
Pickled quail egg.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Slice them up on top of your salad. Put them... make a deviled eggs with them.
With martinis, that's awesome.
Yeah, and also you can use the brine in the martini mix.
Right, right.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, I used to do that. I used to drink pickletinis all the time.
Oh, man.
Until I had too many one night.
Yeah, so they're good. So we got that classic dill flavor. We do a smoked jalapeno, and we do a spicy habanero. And I use brine from Backyard Brine over there in Kutchog, because they do it right. And I don't need to screw around with a recipe, you know, when they've already been doing it right for 4 or 5 years.
It's actually good. It's really good.
Well.
It's a hell of a lot better. The last taste test we did up here was gefilte fish. And that was about 10 years ago.
I don't even like gefilte fish.
They're awful.
What does it taste like?
It's terrible. I don't even know.
You know what
really
it's like?
Exact.
It's like breadcrumbs.
Yeah. It's like wet breadcrumbs.
Exactly. Like wet breadcrumbs.
Why would you want to eat that?
I don't know,
but Steiner liked them. Our mutual friend, Jerry Steiner, loves them.
All right, Nick Ranieri, he grows in Mattituck. He's got an amazing farm, garden, fruit trees everywhere. And his wife was telling me about how she doesn't preserve her artichokes in oil anymore. She uses vinegar because the artichokes would get mushy, and she didn't like that. So she's like, vinegar, a little bit of water, hot peppers and garlic with the artichokes. Stuff them down in there. They're fine.
Can I get my hands on some of those? That sounds great.
Right? Yeah, I'll work on it.
That does sound good. Yeah.
So far, she makes amazing.
So let's see. Abra can be the official pickled quail eggs maker on this show.
Yes, yes.
Gianna's mama.
Got the sauce.
The official sauce maker on the show. You know.
Yeah,
we gotta work on this some more to get like more stuff so I can have an entire meal.
When is the WRIV restaurant opening up?
I don't know.
We'll get some bison down here from Ed.
It's funny you should mention Ed because he's, you know,
did he call in this morning?
No, not yet. He will.
Okay,
I'm
because
sure
I need to know if I'm I, know I need to know if I'm working tonight because I got a deadline to
anyway. Anyway,
because if I'm not working, I gotta write.
This is true stuff. Back when Coates was like hanging around at Tweed's all the time,
I went there.
Anthony Coates. Tony
Coates.
Coates.
I thought you said I was like Coach who?
I went. No, not Coach. Coates.
Coates. Got it. Where is Tony Coates? He's up. He's around.
He's up the island these days.
Really?
Oh. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Anyway, but I had gone there for lunch, and I figured.
Sorry.
I only eat stuff that I'm familiar with.
Right.
Like,
I know. I'm very proud of you. I can't believe you did that.
That was like, for me, that was a big step, Arvin.
I know. I was having
that was a
over
big
there
step.
Hey, man, I appreciate it that you put your life on the line for.
But I did it. I did it because I know you and I trust you.
Oh, that's love.
Oh, Oh, wow. That's, yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
That's love.
Yeah, it is.
It's so touching.
I'm not the most trusting person in the world either, by the way, when it comes to, like, you know, what I ingest. That was really good, though. But anyway,
you keep them refrigerated, though.
Yeah, now that you've opened
them. Yeah, yeah.
Slave boy.
So, hey, tell me.
So I'm sitting, I go there for a hammer because I only get stuff that I'm familiar with, right?
I forgot.
Coates tells whoever is the chef, as it were.
Did he tell you to put an eggplant on it?
No, worse than that. He snuck a bison burger on me.
Oh, why? That's great for you. Especially because it's leaner than chicken. It's a very lean meat.
I noticed this. When it wasn't red on the inside, I noticed it.
It wasn't red on the inside?
No.
He likes it like black and blue.
Exactly. I want to see this little thing walk away.
He wants to see it walk away.
Get back here.
Yeah, there
you go. I want to talk Feisty Acres Farm because she's...
Yeah, we got to do that because she's sitting here.
She's got
these overalls on. But Aubrey's not in uniform today because it's a plaid flannel shirt and not a turtleneck.
I want to know about...
Not the green turtleneck, Aubrey.
It's too hot for a turtleneck, man.
Well, it's too hot for this.
No, it's not. It keeps you cool because when you wear the long sleeves, it shields you from the sun.
I got it.
Yeah.
Or it keeps all the body heat in and
it's cotton, man. It breathes.
It breathes.
It breathes.
And it walks away.
And it walks so,
I want to know about the black silkies. What's the deal with the chickens?
Wait a minute. Can we talk about that on the air?
Yeah.
Black silkies?
Yeah.
That sounds a little like, you know.
Yeah, come on.
Racy?
A little bit. You know?
Because we don't.
Does your mother wear black silkies?
Because we know. We don't know. Yeah, I know. With the very, very controversial logo. Very controversial commercial.
Oh, no.
So let's talk. But so you got guinea hens.
Yes.
You got quail.
Yes.
You got fall partridge.
That's correct.
You got turkeys by accident.
Well, I got turkeys on purpose and by accident.
Oh, yes. Okay.
I actually got double the turkeys that
Double turkeyed. Which is great if you're bowling.
It is, yeah.
Which I don't know if...
I don't know what that means.
It doesn't really exist, okay. but yeah, I guess it does exist.
Right, right.
But turkey is three strikes in a row.
Oh, get out. Oh, all right. Okay, well, yeah, that's great. And
so that would be six, and you probably almost win the game.
Yeah.
So then you got black silky chickens.
Right. So they're black skinned. Silky chickens. So all silky chickens have black skin. It's actually a genetic mutation. They're raised primarily for ornamental purposes, and they're also raised for show. And there are some cultures, particularly Chinese culture, Southeast culture, and some European cultures that covet their black skin and black meat.
Okay. So is it black in color, but is it dark meat or is it like white meat, but it looks black?
So silkies will have white and black, dark meat,
okay.
Just like regular chickens, except their skin is
black.
Correct. And their bones are black. Their internal organs are black.
How cool is that?
They have five toes instead of four. So they're polydactyls.
Wow.
Yes. And, what
can
else?
They grab things?
No, they can't grab things.
They won't become self-aware and like the robots.
No, I don't think so. They have tiny brains.
Yeah, they are chickens.
But and another way that people use these silkies, they're bantam chickens, so that means that they're small. They're also very broody and very friendly, so there are some farm operations and some hobby farmers out there that actually use them to brood chicks of other breeds and also game fowl as well. So Chris and I, my partner at Feisty Acres, we're going to probably keep a couple hens for perhaps hatching out some quail.
Interesting.
Yeah, yeah. So we got a couple of ideas of how we're going to
use them. You can do that? They get so other birds.
Let me tell you a story.
How does that work?
So let me tell you. Here, I'll tell you a story.
Okay, I'm ready.
So my father and I used to live up in Orange County. I lived up there from like age 6 until I was like 12 or 13 years old. And my dad and I had, you know, we had a small garden. We had chickens and ducks. We had two silky chickens. I named them the Dustbuster twins because they looked like little feather dusters. We also had a couple pairs of mallard ducks. And the mallard ducks would lay eggs, the female ducks would lay eggs, but they weren't good mothers and they wouldn't sit on the eggs. So my dad one time found the silky chickens actually setting on the duck eggs.
Wow!
And eventually those duck eggs hatched out.
What?
And the ducklings thought that the silky mother was its mother.
That's amazing.
Yes. So, and that's not uncommon. That actually happens a lot, and people observed this, and they actually use it to hatch out.
So, silky chickens are good moms.
They are good moms, and they're very friendly.
And so, when the duck started to like outgrow its mother.
Oh, it still thought it was his mom.
And
it didn't matter.
And how did the silky chicken mom take care of the giant? Was it just like? Would it try to preen the duck and stuff?
No. I mean, once the ducks get big and everything, they preen themselves. They take their own baths, like dust baths, and they go and they wash themselves in the water and stuff. We had like a pond and everything that they'd go and swim in, and the silky would, you know, wouldn't swim after them, obviously.
Yeah.
But yeah, that happened. I remember that when I was a young girl.
That's
having that
so
happen.
Cool.
Yeah. So, Marco Polo actually is the first Western person to talk about silky chickens in the 13th century when he went to go visit China. And he described them as furry chickens because their feathers don't have the hooks on the ends of them to make them like nice and smooth. So they look like feather dusters.
Well, a very unreliable source.
Marco Polo, yes.
No, not Marco Polo, but a different...
The heck with Marco Polo.
No.
Not spaghetti.
Marco's fine. He's fine by me. Another gentleman. He comes into Amano now and then. And about a month ago or so, he's telling me this story about this black furry cow that he saw on the main road in the middle of the night. That he called the police and he said, there's a black furry cow. There's a black furry cow out here. And he's like, he's sitting with it and it gets hit by a truck. Right? Now, whether or not this happened, I can't say for sure.
Where's the body?
Where is the body? We got to ask.
It was eaten.
We got to ask Mike of the Peconic Ice and Water Company, which may not even be real. I have no idea. This is just a guy.
With a cow story.
Right. But most recently, he came in last night, yeah. And he's telling me he thinks it was a bison.
Wait a minute.
Now he thinks it was a bison.
You're serving guys who come in, like, you know, totally, I'm trying to find a way of putting this nicely.
Oh.
Three sheets to the wind?
No. He's just an unreliable source because he tells me about black furry cows that he sees in the middle of the night that I have not looked up.
Well, first of all, everybody knows that, chocolate milk does come from black cows or brown cows. I think brown cows.
Oh, yeah, totally brown cows. Mm. Yeah, you're right.
Swiss cheese comes from cows with ulcers. I could have seen, like, you know, a cow up there.
I don't even know what to say to that.
I know, this is my struggle, Abra. This is my struggle. Is it time?
Yeah, it's time.
Oh, yeah. It's time. So,
is she with us for the next segment too?
I would love that.
Be fun.
That's fine. Yeah.
Good. I got a good piece of music for you.
And are you gonna read the tweets commercial live when we
come
back?
I'm gonna read it live, but first I have to play Abra's out music.
Okay, oh, nice. Abra out.
I should have queued this up for the vocal.
This is nice.
One night Farmer Brown was taking the air. Locked up the barnyard with the greatest of care. Down in the hen house something stirred. When he shouted, who's there?
Oh,
this is what he heard.
House.
There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So calm yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. We chickens trying to sleep.
Psst. Hey, you. Yeah, you with the face. What's the matter? You ain't never seen a talking bird before? I'm just that good looking, right? That's because I come from good stock, raised right here on the East End of Long Island. What do you think? I'm joking? Feisty Acres is the only farm in the country dedicated to growing certified organic pasture-raised game birds. And we ain't just talking guinea fowl. They got quail, turkeys, fall partridge, black silky chickens. They even sell pickled quail eggs for crying out loud. They're unbelievable, these guys. But don't take my word for it. Check Feisty Acres Farm out yourself at 211 Manor Lane in Jamesport every Saturday between 2 and 5 p.m. Catch them at the Union Square Farmers Market on Wednesdays in Manhattan. Find them on Facebook, Instagram, and don't forget to sign up for their newsletter at FeistyAcres.com for the latest on their Bob White Quail Release Program. Feisty Acres Farm. It's for the birds. The best ones.
Duncan had an idea to create a comfortable place on the East End for families to stay that's cool and contemporary. And you'll find it at the Duncan Inn, 1399 Main Road in Jamesport. Duncan decided that besides cool and contemporary, he'd also add some artwork from his native Scotland. And Duncan isn't leaving anything to chance. Even the sheets are 250 thread count sheets that will help you relax and wake up refreshed and ready for the day's activities. All 20 of his rooms have a workspace, electric outlets, fridges to keep your beverages cold, and a microwave to warm snacks up. But Duncan didn't stop there. For you tea drinkers, Duncan has electric tea kettles in your room so you can enjoy that nice hot cup of tea in the morning. Duncan has Hampton's coffee in the lobby each morning. Snacks, juice, bottled water, and soda. And there's free Wi-Fi. You don't have to go far to enjoy some relaxing time away. Just go over to the Duncan Inn, 1399 Main Road in Jamesport. Duncan's waiting for you.
We're back.
Boy, if only you guys heard the conversation that was just going on out in the hall, as it were.
Well, now we know the difference between hot boxing and a Dutch oven.
I had no idea.
The differences are subtle, but important.
Yeah. One's done in a car, and the other one is done under a blanket.
Under a blanket.
I have to remember this. I almost got thrown out of Jones Beach State Park over that.
Every time Bruce puts his head in his hands, I know I've done my job for the day.
It's good. This show is becoming like the Howard Stern show of the morning.
Yeah, of AM radio.
I know. Now we just need like some, you know, like hot dudes coming.
Well,
in.
We do podcasts. What next? Next, we got to get it on iTunes.
Wait a minute.
They have to come in,
stop,
and then
the
we
tape.
Get to like.
Well, you know how Howard Stern would like bring in these beautiful women,
and then
he'd interview them.
Marker.
Oh yeah, and he'd like sign their breasts and everything.
We
need guys coming in here, you know, and we can sign their chests with a Sharpie.
Oh,
and
girls. Boy.
And girls,
we don't need to.
Yeah.
We don't have to be.
Equal opportunity radio show.
Wait a minute.
Right,
Playboy.
Right,
right. Go get the marker. Go in there and take your shirt off.
Yeah. I have respect and a job.
Yeah. Yo, he says that now.
Steve Hall comes in with a marker.
Steve Hall's coming in with a marker. That's good.
Steve was at Amano last night, and we had Joe Riley of Riley Sellers in Kutchog. I adore Mr. Riley, let me tell you. So he's talking about how Malbec is his favorite grape, right?
Malbec is good.
How can he tell the difference? It's a grape.
Because it's the taste.
Well, it's not, and also too how you have to
how you harvest
as well.
It and how you know
you
when,
pick it off the vine.
When is it? When like, it's time? When it's got enough sugars to take it?
What are you asking else for that winery? We will pick no wine before it's time.
That's true. Let's see. Wait until the sugars are. You gotta go out there and test the bricks.
The bricks test.
So listen. So he's talking.
What did you throw to the bricks? Do you have smashes?
He's adorable. No. Mr. Riley is like the cutest, and he's like, I got this idea, of what I want to call my Malbec, and tell me this isn't a great idea, sex in the Malbec. And I'm just standing behind the bar going, I love you.
I'm not sure that's like, a good one.
It's no. not.
I'm not convinced on it.
But
I'm not,
sounds a lot like
I'm not
sex
buying
in a mailbox.
That one. I'm not buying that one.
Oh, I would.
Mr. Riley, if you're listening.
I'll buy it.
Mr. Riley, if you are listening. It's a really good try. But stay in the same vein. But I don't know, man.
Aubrey won't buy it. I will, Mr. Riley. I'll buy sex in
a mailbox. I got to meet Mr. Riley.
He's adorable. He's adorable.
Welcome to Dial-A-Date.
And Mike, all right, I can't remember. It's like, it's crumbling.
Your boyfriend know about this?
But
I'm pretty sure he's listening right now.
So
oh,
it's
good.
Like, it's like Mike Crum from Duck Walk. I can't.
What, are we going to spend the morning dropping names?
No, but listen, I'm trying to remember how to say his last name. And it's got Crumb in the beginning, so he's like, you could just call me Crumb Cake. He goes, everyone wants a piece of the Crumb Cake.
Holy,
it was a good night.
Sounds like it.
Wind down Wednesday.
Is this
Wednesday.
The same night that that guy came in about the furry
with
cow?
With the furry cow,
it's
yes.
The same night?
Yes.
Was it a full moon?
No. Oh. It's Wine Down Wednesday. Half price bottle of wine with your entree.
I see. So that is
and
the
thread. And they had to drink it all down.
The thread that ties
that's
it all together.
One sitting, yeah.
No. No. And actually, what ended up happening is some guy, I almost called him a Yahoo or something, got this very nice bottle of Amarone. Right.
What is Amarone?
It's wine made with dried grapes.
Oh, okay.
This is
like
opposed
raisins.
To the wet grapes.
So
these are dried grapes.
Like raisins. Remember the California
towel
raisins?
Dry grapes.
Yeah. Exactly.
Towel dry. The baby's butt.
Towel dry. That's right. Terry cloth towel dried raisins grapes.
So
that's why it costs so,
so
much.
This is what this is my read on it because
this
we had
is
Jim
ridiculous
Waters.
Is what
we
it
had
is.
Jim Waters from Waterscrest Winery. We had Mike. We had Mr. Riley. They all tried this Amarone that got returned because the guy said this bottle is corked. This bottle is no good. Like, it's like a $90 bottle of wine.
Oh, my God.
Right? And they all taste it, and they're like, it's fine. So my thinking is that this is just some rich guy who wanted to, like, get an expensive bottle of wine.
Impress people.
But doesn't know what Amarone is and doesn't understand the difference in taste. So he was like, this
there's
is no
a difference
good.
In taste between
so,
different
so
wines?
So he wanted to get another bottle
wait,
opened.
Wait, whoa, stop the tape. There's a difference in taste between different bottles of wine.
Bruce, every week we go over this.
Bruce, do we need to take you out?
We like, got to take
wine
you
tasting?
Out. I think so.
Should we rent one of those elegant limousines?
Yes.
Oh, no, because it's my luck. I'll end up in Cutchog somewhere.
Well,
God
that's
forbid,
what I'm... No.
Route 48.
I used to want to buy that one that was like for sale.
Oh, the old one.
Remember that?
Could have lived in it.
That's what I wanted to do.
I was thinking about that.
And
we were both thinking about
we
that.
We were both having the same thought.
It was kind of a baller limousine.
Yeah, it was.
It was from the 90s.
It was really
it
cool.
It was an old school 90s, like something that
what
Donald Trump
that
would
thing?
Roll around
old
in. Yeah, 1999. 90s. Yeah, no,
1999.
It was sweet, Bruce.
We would have partied
did
like
you not
it was 1999.
No. It was by, wasn't it by the Petulant Wino, or was it further
was,
up?
It was further
by Goodale.
It was by that deli that's oh shoot by what? That by that school
the Meeting House deli it was there.
Yes
the Meeting,
the meeting
House deli.
Deli
yes that's exactly
but
it.
That but across the street where there's like a
oh my god
it's like an auto parts store or something
dude no. Bruce you oh, would have oh. liked it
oh gosh
you would have really liked it was classy.
I know. I remember talking to Laurie Spitz about it.
When you this go up on Sound
the,
Avenue, you can
this
see
is
a
the
lot
name
of old,
dropping
old
show.
Iron.
This is the name drop. Anyone who's anyone. Oh, Mark LaMena of Lucharitos. He's going to start a upstairs. He's going to start like an old style game, like an old game room, and like
oh, with like arcade games.
Old arcade games, and like rent it out. Like you could rent it out for like parties and stuff.
That sounds awesome.
Right?
It's like better than Chuck E. Cheese's.
Right?
It's got
with margaritas, like pictures
it's
of margaritas.
Tacos.
I knew there was something
pictures
I was missing.
Pictures of margarita. That's where I want my birthday.
Oh, let's do it.
I know. We're going to do it.
Your birthday came and went.
This is 2018 though.
Oh. You're planning already?
Yes.
Why not?
For upstairs.
You can never plan too much.
You can't plan too far ahead. And we're still waiting on Aquabog.
What?
Aquabog, the Lucha, Little Luchas.
That's supposed to open already.
It should be Mucharitos.
Oh, gee.
It's going to be like a takeout, I think. It's going to be more takeout. What is this? What? What's the problem?
I can't believe how this show is just like, we're circling the drain, you know that.
Sex in the Malbec?
No.
But think about that. You know what it sounds like?
I love it.
But it sounds like sex in the mailbox.
You good tried point, doing it? Bruce. Good. Bruce, the voice of reason, as always. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, it sounds wrong. You're absolutely right.
What's wrong with having sex in the mailbox?
Are we allowed to say this on the radio?
Yes, we are.
Oh, okay. Just checking.
Bruce would let me know.
Oh, okay.
I said freaking once. See, look at his eyes.
Are we not allowed to say that?
I don't like that word. That doesn't sound good on the radio.
It gets too close. We're getting too close to the edge.
You ever rent the post office box?
Yes.
The little box, you can't even like. You can't even do it in your arm in.
You can't
let
even.
Let alone anything else.
You can't even have sex in the mailbox.
Well, would that be considered like a glory hole?
Wow.
Is that allowed on the radio?
Bruce just
do I have to pay a fine now?
No, but.
Oh, best show ever.
I wrote in my newsletter that there would be hijinks, and so I'm really glad that I didn't lie about it.
Show got hijacked is what happened.
It did. You're as red
here
as
we were talking about.
I'm really embarrassed by that, actually.
Opera turned plaid.
Look at her. She's actually blushing.
Well, I got worried there for a second because I thought I really screwed things up for you.
No, you just surprised him. Is all
shocked is what I was.
Well, I thought that's where we were going with the mailbox.
Well, did I mention that I'm a cardiac patient and I can't?
We blurred the lines.
Once again, friends.
Furry black cows.
I know we're supposed to be talking about black skin chickens.
Yes,
we're talking about mailboxes, Malbec, and
we got close. Things. I mean, it's
This so is actually the best advertising for black meat chickens.
When do you have your first?
But how do you tell when they're done if you roast them?
Well, that's actually a good point, Bruce, because the best. I'm trying to be serious, but no, roasting them actually is not the best way to cook them.
Okay.
They're really great braised and in curries and in soups. No, not broiled. You don't really want to broil them or fry them because they don't have like too much fat on them.
Ah.
So they really lend themselves well to making soups. In fact, the Chinese say that the black silky soup has medicinal properties. Take that as you will. I don't think it's true, but who knows?
You ever have chicken feet?
Yeah, of course.
Is that a common thing for people to eat?
I mean, not here, but everywhere else in the world,
In Mali, you had a lot of chicken feet?
Oh, yeah, people ate feet.
Yeah.
Oh, totally. I ate a goat's eyeball.
Nice.
Yeah.
How was that?
It was gross.
It was gross.
I ate it to be polite.
Yes.
How uplifting.
There we go.
Yeah.
That's very nice. I ate the chicken feet because I was...
And you should know, Miss Volpe, given that your name... Given that your name isn't a vowel, you should know the old line Italians
eat
calf brains.
Cat brains.
Calf brains.
Oh, calf brains.
Yeah, everyone eats calf brains.
God.
What's that disease?
Mad cow disease?
Yeah, isn't that where it's from? Actually from eating brains?
That's cows eating other cows and...
But people can get it from eating brains.
From infected cows, yeah.
But isn't it not just cows? It's actually from brains?
I don't know.
That's what I heard. I also heard that
I think
there
we should check
tribe.
Our sources.
I also
Why
I
would
also,
we do that?
Because that's important.
I thought that's important.
It's very important.
Why would we do that?
Because journalism.
Because so, journalism.
Because nobody does it anymore.
Bruce.
That's what journalism is. Providing democracy, the public, with the right information to form a better union.
His head is in his hands.
That's the
again.
Job. That's all it is.
To form
forget.
Their opinions.
What?
A journalist provides accurate, vetted information to help people form opinions.
That's correct.
Yes.
And to be form informed.
A, to form
the better union part.
I know she's getting all socialist about this.
I'm not getting socialist. I'm spitting straight J school knowledge.
Yeah.
J school.
You know what the next thing she's gonna say is? Workers of the world unite. You have nothing to lose but your chains.
Oh, give me a break.
You don't even know who said that.
I will walk out of this radio
Karl
station.
Marx?
Yeah, it was, wasn't it?
I mean, I'm just guessing because you're saying communism stuff to me and saying that I don't know what to...
Why? I'm a member of the proletariat.
So am I.
I'm not a member of the bourgeoisie.
Neither am I.
I'm an ordinary proletarian.
I'm both. How's that? You like that?
Barbara, on the other hand...
We're both.
I'm a capitalist. I like to make money. I want to spend money here in the local community. I very strongly believe that we can better ourselves through, you know, making money, starting businesses, working hard. And
working
I think it's really important for people's hard work to be rewarded. And if you don't work hard, then you don't get rewarded. And it's as simple as that.
I like that.
So
By the way,
does that mean I get rewarded soon?
Who's going to get rewarded?
I want to get rewarded because I work like an animal.
Well, you know, keep working, Jane.
I am.
Anyway.
I won't stop.
Feisty Acres.
Yes.
I want to get one of these black skin chickens. What do I got
to
do?
Saturday, 2 to 5.
12 to 5.
12 to 5.
12 to 5.
Manor Lane.
Jamesport.
Or at the Union Square Farmers Market in Manhattan, which we didn't even talk about.
The one in the city, right? Not the one in Kansas.
No, not the one in Kansas.
Okay.
No.
I don't know how
I would be able to make money going all the way to Kansas. No, but yeah, it's kind of a big deal. I applied for the Union Square Farmers Market. I did it. I said, hey, why not? You know, I used to go to the Union Square Farmers Market when I went to school in Manhattan. I went to Bernard Baruch College, which is a business school. And I used to go there on Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, and I used to go and get food for lunch. And it's huge. I mean, there's over 100 vendors there. And what's really cool is that Union Square is a part of the Green Market, and the Green Market in New York City. And so in order to get into any of the farmers markets run by Green Market, your farm actually has to be inspected. So if you say that you're growing black, you know, you're growing silkies, they ask you how many you're going to raise, where do you slaughter them, and all this other stuff. And they come to your farm and they inspect and they make sure that you are actually growing what you are selling.
That's so there's, awesome.
So there's a lot of farms that get denied.
Checking their sources. I like it.
No, it's true. Yeah. So.
Oh, we got to wrap up.
Oh, yeah. So there you go. Yeah. Big deal. Come visit me every Wednesday starting June 7th, Union Square. Be there.
Or 211 in Jamesport, Manor Lane. 211 Manor Lane in Jamesport.
That's right.
Saturday is 12 to 5 p.m.
Yep.
We'll be here next week, Thursday morning, on 1390 WRIV, your hometown station.
An overhead door serves a purpose, and it should be as beautiful as the rest of your home or building. For more than 30 years, Village Overhead Doors has been creating and installing beautiful garage doors for contractors and homeowners on the North and South Forks. They also install automatic garage door openers that open with the click of a remote, so there's no getting out of the car in bad weather. For a wide range of styles, from lifetime steel doors to custom-made wood doors, and for all your garage door needs, please call 765-4963 today and find out how your garage door can be a beautiful focal point of your home or building's exterior. Village Overhead Doors of Southold. 765-4963. Make the call and let them add beauty and value to your home or business.
The Crazy Fork on the main road in Matatuck is the place for entertainment on the North Fork. From live comedy to music to the Revolution No. 9 variety shows, you'll have a good time. The Crazy Fork is comfy but classy, and the food is good. Whether you're looking for fish tacos or lobster mac and cheese, or a steak or seafood, you'll love the Crazy Fork. The Crazy Fork also serves homemade pizza and a sandwich for every taste. So don't stay home tonight. Come on out. Have some fun at the place for entertainment on the North Fork, the Crazy Fork. The Crazy Fork on the main road in Matatuck. Call 631-298-1100 for the Crazy Fork in Matatuck.